Hey everybody, YouTube, this is Kuri Mike, and today I want to show you how to make breakfast stuffed crust pizza. I'm going to make it with homemade pizza crust and homemade gravy. So let's begin, shall we? First off, we're going to start by making the pizza crust, which calls for 1/4 cup of warm water, 1 packet of dry yeast, 1 teaspoon of granulated sugar, and 1/4 cup of bread flour. And then you stir it up until it's nice and blended. And then you cover it up and store it to a warm place for 20 minutes. After the 20 minutes, you uncover it and then add 1 cup of warm water and 3 cups of bread flour. And to that you add 2 sticks of melted unsalted butter, 4 teaspoons of garlic powder, 1 teaspoon of salt. And then you mix it up until it's fully incorporated with the dough. Place the dough on a lightly floured surface and then knead it for about 5 to 10 minutes. And next, take some olive oil and lightly coat the bowl with it. Take the dough and put it inside the bowl and then rub it around until it's nice and coated. If you want to, you can add some more olive oil to it. And then cover it up and then put it in a warm place for 1.5 to 2 hours. And next we're going to work on the homemade gravy. Now ahead of time I already cooked the bacon and sausage. And this is the grease that is left from that. And this will be the base for your gravy. Now we're going to add 1 cup of all-purpose flour, set it to medium heat, and then stir it up until it becomes chunky. And to that, you add 2 cups of milk. If that's not enough, you could add some more milk to it. Keep stirring it until the chunks become thinner. And this is how the gravy should look like after you're done with it. If you want to, you can add some cracked pepper or some ground black pepper. And then stir it up until it's nice and blended with it. And while the dough is rising, this will be a good time for you to cook the eggs and meats, as well as grating the cheese and stuff. Take the dough out and re-knead it for about 5 more minutes. Now place the dough on a pizza sheet and spread it out until it completely covers the pizza sheet. Now here I messed up. As you can see, I forgot to stuff the crust and then pour the gravy, but instead I did it backwards. So when you do it, be sure to stuff the crust first and then pour the gravy. And the cheese I'm using is a sharp cheddar. But you can use any cheese you want to stuff it. And now roll the dough over the cheese and make sure you pinch it under the crust. Now spread the gravy all inside the dough, making sure it's completely covered. And after that, load up with cheese. And the cheese that I'm using a combination of mild cheddar and Monterey Jack. Now you could use any cheese you want to on it. And on top of that, I'm pouring some pork sausage. And then I put in some scrambled eggs on top of that. And then I'm adding some applewood smoked bacon on top of it. And this is some smoked ham that I'm putting on top. Cooked, fully cooked. And then I add some more cheese because I like my piece of a lot of cheese on it. And to top it all off, I'm putting some green onions on it, or scallions, or whatever you call it. And then I'm going to put it in the oven for about 40 minutes on 350 degrees. After it's done, this is how it should look like. This was a very, very thick pizza, and I enjoyed every bit of it. I could only finish two slices. It took me about 5 hours to make this. And if you don't want it to take that long, then I suggest you make the dough ahead of time. Like, make the dough the night before, and then put it in the refrigerator so it can have a slow rise. And if you're grating your own cheese, then I suggest you do that ahead of time also. The full recipe will be in the bottom of the description. So if you like breakfast and you like pizza, then I would give this a try. Thank you for watching.